What's the difference between Microsoft Copilot Chat versus Microsoft 365 Copilot? Let's dive into this right now. They have similar names. Microsoft Copilot Chat, by the way, is also known as simply Copilot Chat. That is available to everyone that has a Microsoft business license, whether it's standard or premium. Microsoft Enterprise license, this is your E3, E5 accounts. And if you're on the education side, the enterprise would be, I think, an A3 and an A5. Everyone has Microsoft Copilot Chat. You can do web searches, and you also have enterprise data protection. I will actually demonstrate this in just one second. The Microsoft 365 Copilot, this one's easy to identify because, one, there's a fee involved, and it's an annual subscription. It is $30 a month. It must be paid annually, so that's $360 a year for a user. That user still needs a Microsoft 365 account, so it's technically an add-on to their account. But with the Microsoft 365 Copilot license, this is when you'll have Copilot available to you in the Microsoft 365 apps. Excel, Word, PowerPoint, Teams, OneNote, OneDrive, Microsoft Forms. I'm probably forgetting some of the apps, but those are some of the big ones where I use Copilot all the time. So let's take a look at how your screen will appear differently depending on what license, whether you have the license or not. So I am going to first pull up my Copilot. So because I have a license, when I pull up Copilot, I have the Work tab and the Web tab. Web tab, I can just ask questions about stuff. I could upload a Word document. I could upload a PDF file and ask questions about that. If you do not have the license, the $30 a month, you're still going to have this screen, but this Work and this Web will not appear. So let me show you this real quick using Carol's account. Carol is with Chris Menard Training. Carol is signed in and she's being asked, do you want to use Copilot Chat? And she's going to hit Add Copilot. Notice Carol's screen with Copilot does not have Work and Web at the top. There's also the URL on how to get to Copilot, m365.cloud.microsoft/chat. She's in here. Carol can also upload Word files, PDF files, other document types, and ask questions about it. As an example, we could upload the annual report for a company. I'm picking on NVIDIA, and Carol could ask it, what was the annual revenue for 2024, and Copilot would look at that Word document and come back, or PDF file, and come back and tell her the answer. She could even ask, what was the revenue for the gaming division or the gaming segment? And if it's in that Word document or PDF, Copilot will come back and return it. Great feature there. What Carol cannot do, because she doesn't have the license that is paid for, the $30 a month, Carol cannot ask questions about, go find this email in my Outlook that is from so-and-so, or summarize all my emails for the past 2 weeks. I'm just using examples. Another way to know if you have an M365 Copilot license, I'm going to pull up. I have my Microsoft Excel working. There's my profile picture in the top right. I have Copilot here on the ribbon. It's in the same place in Word, PowerPoint. It's in OneNote also. So you'll have Copilot here, and I can ask questions about my Excel file. I can ask for formulas. I can ask for conditional formatting. A lot of stuff you can do. I've got a long list of videos listed in the description with me using M365 Copilot. Carol pulls up her Excel. She is not going to have Copilot listed on the ribbon. So there's that option. I hope this helps clarify things. I will write a blog post on this and put those screenshots in there so you can see the comparison when you have Copilot pulled up, a licensed user with a license versus someone that doesn't have a license but yet has a business or an enterprise account. I appreciate your time. My training for Copilot, Teams, Excel is available online. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.